Welcome to ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray, your software solution for volume data analysis. In this video, we'll have a look at the user interface. Let's dive right in and open the ZEISS Quality Suite, your platform for metrology software, services, news, and updates. When you start it, you'll get a little tour, so feel free to take a look. If you want to try ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray, take a look at the description below. There you'll find links to download the software, request a free trial, and download training data. Please log in. Or register for a ZEISS ID if you don't have one yet. Under All Applications, you can see and install all available applications. Once you installed them, you can either click on an application and start it from here, or go to My Applications to open them. And for even faster access, you can add applications to the menu bar and launch them directly. ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray opens with the Start screen. Here, you can create a new project, open an existing project, or a recently used project. You always need a project to work with the software. Through the Start screen, you can also access the ZEISS Quality Tech Guide and Training Center. Here, you'll find more information and trainings for your software and hardware products. But back to the Start screen. If you want to play around with the software, but have no data available, you can download sample data. The software redirects you to the ZEISS Quality Suite, where you can download free example projects. I'll open a recently used project to explain the user interface. Let's start with the multi-view. The multi-view is a flexible layout designed to support workflows in both 2D and 3D. I'm currently using one of the default templates, the orthogonal view. That means the software displays three sections in 2D, which are orthogonal to each other, and the 3D view in the bottom right corner. Now, I won't get into detail about what you can do thanks to the multi-view just yet. Let's just say it vastly improves visual inspections. Instead, I want to focus on the general handling. Up here, in the main toolbar, you can switch between different layout templates. You can work with single 3D view, switch to volume detail view, where the three volume sections are displayed on the right side, or use the rotation view, where you can use the axis to change the view. But you can also build custom templates using the function layout template. Decide how many panels you want, or use these commands to insert or delete rows and columns. Then, drag and drop the window you want to display onto the respective panel. Once you're happy with your layout, click Apply. If you want to reuse the layout, you can save it as a layout template here. So much for customizing the layout of your main work area. Let me switch back to the orthogonal view before we continue. To make it easier to work with each of the views, you can expand and minimize them with a single click. As for the navigation, you can zoom in and out using the mouse wheel. You can pan the object by pressing the mouse wheel. You can use the coordinate system in the bottom left corner to adjust the view. The options here depend on the view. For 2D views, you can rotate. For the 3D view, you can rotate, but also display a standard or isometric view, for example. Now here's where the commands differ depending on the view. In the 2D views, so the section view Z, X, and Y, you can use Alt and the mouse wheel to move the respective axes through the part. If you want, you can change the setting under Edit Preferences and use only the mouse wheel to move the axes. To do that, you need to set Use Alt for Zoom in Section Views to Yes. Alternatively, you can use the spin box up here. You can drag any axis in the section views to adjust the position of the viewing section. And you can set a focus point, which affects all three of the 2D views. In the 3D view, you can turn the object with the left mouse button, and if you want to rotate the object to the left or right, use Shift and the left mouse button. For a better overview, the 3D view offers the option to show the section planes. This allows you to see which area of the part you're currently looking at in the section views. In addition, the 3D view also offers clipping functionalities, which we won't cover in these videos. But you can find more information about clipping in the tech guide. Alright, so much for this introduction to the multi-view. To find out more about how to use it, check out the video How to Perform Visual Inspections in ZEISS Inspect X-Ray. Now, let's move on to workspaces and the main toolbar. On the left side, you find the different workspaces. Workspaces are dedicated to assignments such as volume inspection, reporting, and mesh editing. If you switch between workspaces, the main toolbar changes to provide the tools you need for your tasks in the specific workspace. It's designed to guide you through the main steps in each workspace. Start brings you back to the start screen. The Explorer contains a tree of all elements in your project, whether they have been imported or created during your inspection. The elements are divided into different categories, such as measurements, part, which can have a name like in this case, and report pages. Under measurements, you'll find the measured volume data. Under part, you'll find all the elements for the analysis of a part. That means nominal and actual data, as well as inspection elements, and so on. Everything is well organized and easy to find. If you want to display elements in the multi-view, just drag and drop them into the multi-view with the left mouse button. When you do that, the elements will be displayed exclusively. You can also select them in the Explorer and use the keyboard shortcut E. If you want to display an element in addition to the content in the multi-view, toggle the visibility here or use the keyboard shortcut V. Now, in addition to the layout of the multi-view, you can customize the entire user interface of ZEISS Inspect X-Ray, meaning you can display the information you need exactly where you want it. All you need to do is drag and drop the different windows into the respective docking areas on the left, the right, or the top. And the software even supports multiple monitors. To add a window, click the plus. To reset the layout to the default, click View, Screen Setup, Reset All Workspaces. Underneath the main toolbar, you'll find the status bar. The colors provide information about your project and let you know if there's anything you need to address. For more details, look at the project guide. Here, you'll find a comprehensive list of all hints and warnings divided into different categories. This list is designed to guide you through the troubleshooting process and suggests possible actions. Now, if you want to view or change the properties of an element in your project, you can do that in the Properties window here. The content of the Properties window depends on the element you selected in the Explorer or the multi-view. For volume data, for example, you can change the colors for different materials, select a color template, and adjust the transparency. We'll talk more about the options here in the video How to Perform Visual Inspections in ZEISS Inspect X-Ray. The tab Information provides information about the volume data and measurement parameters. To evaluate your part in ZEISS Inspect X-Ray, you typically need an alignment. A project can contain several alignments, and you can switch between them at any time. When you switch to another alignment, the software automatically recalculates all the elements because an alignment change affects the inspections in the project. You can also create a new alignment at any point in time. Next, we'll look at the 3D toolbar. Like the name suggests, you can find it on the bottom of the 3D view. It contains various selection commands. To find more selection commands, open Edit, Selection in 3D. You can add these selection commands and any other function to the 3D toolbar by using drag and drop. You can also reorganize the tools in the 3D toolbar and delete them. Alternatively, you can access the most important selection commands by clicking the right mouse button on the background in the 3D view. If you're looking for a software function or more information, use the search function here. The results are divided into functions and help. When you click on a function, the function dialog opens and you can proceed to use the function. If you click on an entry under help, the ZEISS Quality Tech Guide opens in the ZEISS Quality Suite. You can also open the Tech Guide from any dialog window by clicking the question mark. In the Tech Guide, you'll find information about workflows, software functionalities, and parameters. That's it for this introduction to the user interface. To start working with the software, take a look at the video How to Import and Edit Volume Data in ZEISS INSPECT X-Ray. And if you're looking for a more comprehensive training, check out the INSPECT X-Ray Basic e-learning. You'll find the link in the description below.